Welcome to the Health and Wellbeing Board meeting, formal meeting. First item is to just record any apologies.
Apologies received from Councillor Jeffrey, Dave Hopkinson, Sheena Kinsey, David Allenson, and Anne Hall.
And we also go to Councillor Jones to make his apologies.
Okay, thank you. Yes.
Chair, I just said we've got Phil Davis replacing.
Phil Davis?
The we need to spell his name and then try to.
Good, welcome everybody. We'll record those apologies. Right, so item two is the standing item about declarations of interest. Has anybody wish to declare any interest in any particular item? Say now or rather. Chris.
Can I declare that it's just because I would like to see that in the extension?
Right. Okay. Okay, so we'll call that, thank you. Item 3 minutes of our last meeting on the last formal board meeting held on the 13th of February. I'm assuming that everybody's had an opportunity to read those minutes. So can I just invite you to read them as a true record? key sort of issues that were highlighted today in this paper. Any comments, questions, queries? Anyone wants to raise?
Probably easily modified when we've got a replace. For multiple occasions, we're anxious to find assessment needs assessment development. In the bullet point, it begins membership to a different direction than we have this time. The last sentence in that talks about for full details, see the PNADGTOR, which I assume is found assessment needs assessment development in terms of reference.
I terribly sorry, but I can't hear you. I do apologise for speaking out of sound, but I just can't hear what you're saying.
I'll try and speak up.
Thank you.
I'm not entirely clear from the paper. My issue here is that other health and wellbeing boards do include these organisations. I think I'm getting slightly embarrassed because I think hardly a month ago was part of it, and I don't get a letter from them, certainly from the police commissioner, saying I sit on all the other health and wellbeing boards apart from Wirral. I think myself, I understand where you're coming from, Bill, and clearly this is already a large board, and you know the danger is it just becomes unwieldy. However, I think what Keogh was suggesting is if we have an executive group that does the sort of detailed work between meetings, then that will in a sense create some more space, if you like, within the agendas of the board. But I think as chair, I'm struggling to keep on batting off these requests when other health and wellbeing boards do include these key players on the grounds that they have a key role in the wider health and wellbeing agenda. So that's all I would kind of throw to the table. Yeah, in that case. Basis. see, let's just trial it, let's just see how it goes. For, I mean, I'll suggest 6 months. And then if it's clearly becoming a real deal or if it's duplicated, then we can review it again. But I do think we need to widen our membership to improve a kind of wider term to help the pitch. I'm just a bit concerned we're not doing that. So it would just be on a sort of trial basis initially, but if it clearly doesn't work, then we can always change it again.
Yeah.
those changes and let's do another review in 6 months' time of terms of reference membership, etc., groups, and we can make any further changes at that stage if things are not going well. Can we go with that? Yeah. Right, brilliant. Thank you very much. So that then takes us on to item 5. Health Funding Board, Action Plan.
Thank you, Chair. People will recall that we had signed up our health funding strategy in our calendar year. We signed up in March 2013, so we have to have 12 months. Part of the reporting mechanism we said that we thought we were on a quarterly basis, and we asked the board to come together. So today, we need to look at the action plan together, which identifies those items which are not really on time, including that liability and the commentary within the board as to why they have to live on time and mitigating actions. But we also highlighted in the board action on our three priority areas which we want to bring to your attention. We thought the most important thing from the report that you've got in front of you is really to discuss the next iteration. With regard to the strategy that we have in the center this time this year was fit for purpose as then, which is not now, even if anything's happened in the past 12 months, whether that be 2012 to 2018, best term, all the changes that happened within the public sector. So within the paper, we've got based on current strategy, and also a request to raise and consider how they need could be produced during the war. So this was again something that was highlighted in the work that then promised to do and certain feedback that we got from ourselves so to do that work and work that we need to do in the summer last year was that we needed to refresh the memory security and to make sure that we were focused on the next areas and the action needs to get on and do that.
Thanks, Stuart. Right. Comments? Questions?
Phil? Just ask the Chair and the tenders. Section 8, there's two sections where tenders are either waiting for tender exercises commencement. So I'm assuming that works teams and new provider comes to them fairly regularly when new provider, whoever it might be, or is it provider, whoever it might be. I'm assuming things suddenly stop and wait for new provider. The continuity